Are Prince Harry and Meghan Markle engaged? What was the We're in Love interview about and what might their wedding plans be? Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's relationship is continuing to blossom, with the pair appearing closer and more in love than ever. After recently making their first appearance at a public event together, the pair have since enjoyed afternoon tea with the Queen. There's the latest on the couple and rumors of a royal engagement. Glamorous actress Meghan, who plays sassy Rachel Zane in legal drama Suits, first met Harry last year after being introduced by mutual friends. But it wasn't until November that Kensington Palace confirmed the pairing with a statement, saying the prince was worried for her safety. Soon after, Harry and Meghan, who is 4 years his senior, were spotted hand in hand for the first time, while out on a date in London. At the time, pals said actress Meghan had virtually moved into Harry's cottage at Kensington Palace, with the couple having been inseparable for weeks. Meghan has also previously been married after tying the knot with film producer Trevor Ingelson, but they split after 2 years. On May 6, Meghan made her first public appearance as royal girlfriend when she proudly watched Prince Harry playing polo in Berkshire. In September, the pair were pictured together in Toronto as they attended the Invictus Games, Prince Harry's sporting competition for wounded service personnel. During the game's closing ceremony, the pair were spotted in an embrace, and at one point the pair shared a kiss. It came as they sat in the stadium beside Meghan's mum Doria. In early October, it was reported Harry had taken Meghan to Buckingham Palace for a meal with his grandmother, Her Majesty the Queen. In September 2017, Meghan gave her first interview about boyfriend Prince Harry. She told Vanity Fair of her, "We're a couple. We're in love. I'm sure there will be a time when we will have to come forward and present ourselves and have stories to tell, but I hope what people will understand is that this is our time. This is for us. It's part of what makes it so special, that it's just ours. But we're happy. Personally, I love a great love story. We were very quietly dating for about 6 months before it became news, and I was working during that whole time. And the only thing that changed was people's perception." Meanwhile, Prince Harry has remained tight-lipped over the romance, and hasn't spoken about it publicly at all. Most friends have kept their lips firmly sealed regarding Harry and Meghan's relationship. Kirstie Ennis, a former U.S. Marine and Paralympic hopeful, let it slip that a wedding might be on the cards when quizzed by reporters about attending the ceremony. When pressed for more information, she immediately pleaded the fifth, the American term used when a person wishes to stay silent on an issue. In August, a former royal chef suggested Harry will propose to Meghan in the run-up to Christmas. Meghan's brother Thomas Markle Jr. has now said Harry needs to get on with proposing to his TV star sister. Speaking to the Daily Mail, the 51-year-old of Grants Pass, Oregon said, "I hope Prince Harry proposes. She's a hot commodity right now, he better get on it." If Harry and Meghan do tie the knot, the American actress will be given a royal title by the Queen, but according to royal expert Imogen Lloyd Webber, she would not immediately become Princess Meghan because you can't become royal through marriage. She told People magazine that as Harry's title is His Royal Highness Prince Henry of Wales, her official tag would be Her Royal Highness Princess Henry of Wales. Instead, Harry, 32, would be bestowed a dukedom when he ties the knot, much as William became the Duke of Cambridge. Imogen believes the pair would become the Duke and Duchess of Sussex if they did take the plunge. The Duke and Duchess of Clarence and Buckingham are also available, as the line has died out, so they are in the Queen's gift to bestow.